Hi, I'm Dominic. Thanks for watching Dominic's Woodworks. Know these things? Chris Pine recently made a holder for his one, and he reminded me that I got one too. Sitting on a shelf, gathering dust, so why not make a special holder for it? And I have an idea how I can put a spin on it. For starters, I'll be making it from this. Finest wooden ash. Wait, there's been a mistake somewhere. I mean, this kind of ash. Let's see what we can do.
I freehand the Bing. Shape of a hand Bing. Onto a block of ash. Since I want the fingers bent, I only trace handy circles Bing. On the piece. To avoid having to make sharp turns at the bandsaw, I use a Forstner bit to hog out some material next to the fingers. Actually, the Forstner bit had its hands full Bing. With the ash and burned quickly. So I got my hands Bing. On a spade bit, which worked a lot better. Since my drill press does not extend that far, I finish the holes with a piece of sacrificial board that doubles as a spacer underneath. On the bandsaw, I cut along the lines, using the holes to turn the piece. Of course, I keep my hands Bing. Away from the blade. I like my hands. Bing. They come in handy, Bing. As they are. Since I need two hands, Bing. I then resaw the piece. At first I was afraid that it would not go through, but tilting it did the trick. From there, I handed it Bing. Over to the sander combo, but after a moment I realized that sanding it would be pointless since next I take to my rasps for a little hand-on Bing. Shaping. I try for a good mix of natural shapes and artistic license, which translates to getting my hands dirty Bing. While keeping my hands clean. Bing. Confusing, right? What I mean to say is that I did not want to get lost in shaping, so I went for a more artistic representation of a hand.
Bing.
Which in turn probably translates to me being lazy, but I would certainly deny that. To make the fingers, I took a second slab of ash and cut off several slices on the table saw. I referenced off one of the hands for Bling. The required thickness. As you can see, I hand fit the large slab, but to cut the actual fingers I used my push block, since that is hands down Bling. The safest thing to do. The fingers are then shaped to the size and form of their spot on the hand Bling. On the sanding disc. To a hand-drawn pencil line. I then proceed to shape the tip, first on the disc, then on the belt, referencing of my own fingers for a slight degree of realism. I use CA glue to attach the fingers once they are all done, and sand over the joints where possible. I do the fingers for the upper hand,
Bling.
Yes, it's always good to keep the upper hand,
Bling.
The same way, but they need to be bent in order to hold the tube of the thermometer. To do that, I get my hands on Bing. A piece of plastic pipe that is almost the same diameter as the glass, and will not break if mishandled.
Bling.
To be clear, it was a little larger, which gives me a little cushion for error. I place this tube on top of the hand,
Bling.
Yes, the upper hand,
Bling.
And this handy setup Bling. Gives me a simple way to trace the base of the fingers onto the piece. I then outline what I perceive as a good shape and cut it out on the bandsaw. I can always come back to check. A word on crane flow. While it would really be cool to have the crane flow intact between palm and fingers, I only had the two pieces of ash you saw on hand,
Bling.
So I decided offhand Bling. To just call it, you guessed it, artistic license. Boy, am I glad that this license comes without any fees. Just like before, the fingers get their shape on the sander, the disc where possible and the belt where necessary. After gluing the fingers to the hand, Bling. I use a file to smooth over the roughest parts. Seeing how tedious this handheld Bling. Sanding and filing was, and how hard to get a proper handhold on it without breaking off a finger, I realized that my enjoyment of shaping wood with aggressive tools like rasps is by no means matched by my enjoyment of sanding it smooth afterwards. To accommodate the tip of the thermometer, I drill a hole into the, wait for it, upper hand.
Bling.
The backer board is made from walnut, and I round it over and shape it similar to the glass, just like Chris Pine did. I attach the hands with Bling. Screws from the back, pre-drilled, sunk, and carefully screwed in by hand.
Bling.
For the finish, I wanted to use beeswax, yet again, and this time I managed to acquire a pot for my induction plate. I dip the hand Bling. In molten wax, and of course I end up with a layer of hardened wax on the wood, which leads me back to the hot air gun. Inspired by Lynn over at Darbin Ora, I mixed some of the wax with paint thinner. I'm not sure whether to call it a success, especially since I free-handed the ratio, but it still gives a nice finish on the backboard and the, yes, upper hand.
Bling.
But in comparison, the maltreated hand looks a little stronger in color than the one rubbed with the waxy stuff. I honestly don't remember whether the thermometer was a hand-me-down or where I got my hands on it, but I think it's in good hands now.
And here we go. Once again, it doesn't fit the screen completely, but... Oh, there it is. I'll probably put up some pictures. And I don't know if you can see this, but this hand looks much better than this one. This I used with the, well, the full wax treatment and the hot air gun. This one got the wax and thinner treatment, rubbing it in. It's way lighter than this one. I thought about doing the dipping with this hand as well, but I kind of want to see how it ages, which is another way to say that I'm too lazy. Put that up somewhere in the living room and... Hopefully it gets warmer soon, so we can actually use it. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please consider subscribing to my channel if you're not already. And please share the video with your friends or with your enemies to have a heated discussion over thermometers. Thanks for watching, and remember to be inspired.